questions on that? All right. So as far as the degree evaluation online, first-time freshmen will have access to their degree evaluation by the first day of classes. Due to a programming change last year, they may actually have access to it on the day that they register. So for, and if they don't, they will have access by the first day of classes. For a transfer student, first of all, the WPA. All transfer students must take the WPA in the fall 2017 semester. If they fail to do so, they will have a hold on their registration. They will not be allowed to register for spring. So this is a change this year to the catalog only. So in past catalog years, under degree requirement number 2, which is the WAR, under the score breakdown, it explains that a 10 or higher equals no class unless one is required by the major. An 8 or a 9 equals one approved upper division course, and a 7 or lower is one required lower division course and one approved upper division course. In the 2017-18 catalog, it remains the same with a 10, but it now states an 8 versus an 8 and a 9, and a 6 or lower versus 7 or lower. So the reason behind this is there was actually no score of 9 or 7. It's been that way for a while. There hasn't been a score of 9 or 7. They just never updated the catalog. So now they have. And the only reason I'm pointing it out is we want to get in the habit. I know I'm in the habit of saying 7 or lower and 8 or 9. We just want to get in the habit of saying 6 or lower, because a student may say, well, that's not what my catalog says. So where's this mysterious 7? Any questions on that? So for transfer students, lower division general education may be certified and completed from a transfer school, so a California Community College, a UC, or a CSU. If the lower division general education is completed and certified, instead of seeing each area on the degree evaluation, there will be a small box that says lower division general education completed by transfer certification. If you see an evaluation where instead of seeing the small box that I just talked about, you can see that every area says transfer certified except for one area, typically it's humanities. Advise the student to wait on registering for a lower division humanities until they have spoken to an advisor. So then we want you to come get one of us and just ask us to look at the degree evaluation regarding their lower division general education. Okay, so we can help out with that student further. So again, talking about 2T, 2X, and 4T courses, they are college-level courses that we have accepted, but they're not exactly equivalent to an SDSU course. So they will be listed on the degree evaluation as, remember, just look at that 2T or 2X if they're lower division, or 4T. Ignore the other letters and numbers that come after that. So again, these courses may fulfill a GE requirement, but if they want to use them to satisfy a major requirement, they're going to have to petition. And then in order to petition, they're going to have to prepare that request for adjustment of academic requirement, also referred to as a RAR, and then you can refer them to the major department. Unknown courses. So you'll see unknown courses listed as at the very end of the degree evaluation, and on the left-hand side where you typically see whether they're a direct equivalent or a 2T or a 2X or a 4T, it'll simply say UNKWN in all capital letters. So these are courses that were not already in our database when the transcript was received. So an evaluation of the course has to be done by an evaluator in the academic advising office. So unknown should be identified by the end of the fall semester. If the student believes that an unknown course will satisfy a GE, a major, or another graduation requirement, we want the student to avoid enrolling in that specific course. They should wait until the course is identified by the end of the fall semester and focus on taking other courses that they know they still need. Questions on this? Yes.
So they need to go and ask one of the academic advisors or
them, and they will be identified by the end of the fall semester, but we're not going to do them on the spot, one by one.
So they don't need to.
Right. They just have to wait for us to identify it, and then they may have to petition if they're not happy with the way we identify the course. And if they think they have a similar course, or that course is a course that's required, then they just want to avoid that course and take something else. Yes?
How will they know the course is identified? Do they need to go to an advisor and ask, like, has this been identified?
That's a great question. They'll get an email telling them that their degree evaluation has been released, and that will be their indication to go look, and then they'll be able to see. We won't release a degree evaluation with unknowns on it. Yeah. Any other questions? All right, so specialized GE pattern. So engineering, nursing, liberal studies, and single subject credential majors must follow the GE requirements outlined on their degree evaluation and in their major section of the catalog. So a reminder for an AAT or an ADT for transfer students. So there is an associate degree for transfer students, often referred to as an AAT or an ADT. For the students that have an ADT, an approved ADT major, the degree evaluation will have the relevant information. If a student thinks there is something incorrect on their evaluation, then just go ahead and grab an academic advisor so we can take a look at that. As far as when their degree evaluation will be available to them in their web portal, they will have access sometime during the fall semester, and they'll be notified once it's available. So just some reminders and or updates and what student population is most relevant to. So this is relevant mainly to transfer students. So for GE Explorations, engineering students are required to take an upper division GE Humanities course that needs to be from the same department as one of their lower division GE Humanities. The evaluation will automatically pull the list for the student. They just need to pick one. Sometimes the student gets confused, they see the three lists, and they think they need three courses in one area. Then they're going to need the second course from Exploration Social and Behavioral, and their third course needs to be also another from Social and Behavioral. Or they can take an upper division American Institutions course only if their American Institutions hasn't been completed with lower division coursework. Because it's being used for an explorations course, the same rules apply. They have to be 60 units passing or passed. Okay. Any questions? Science and math majors. So they need a course from Explorations B and a course from Explorations C. For Explorations A, they have the following options. They can take an additional course from B, or an additional course from C, or they can take an upper division American Institutions, again, only if they have not completed their American Institutions with lower division coursework. And again, same 60 units passed or passing rule applies. So that's mainly going to be relevant for transfer students, but if a first-time freshman asks about this, it's okay to let them know about it, but just remind them that they have to wait on taking their explorations until they're passing 60 units. Okay? This is relevant mainly to first-time freshmen. So in the courses that we call our Golden Four, which is the Oral Communication, the GE Composition, the Intermediate Composition and Critical Thinking, and the Math, incoming freshmen must get a C- or better in order to complete that requirement and move on. This is relevant to both first-time freshmen and transfers. We just talked about this. This is the second year that SDSU now offers American Sign Language 1, 2, and 3. They're listed in ELE as 101, 102, and 201. For those students that want to complete their language requirement for a Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Arts and Sciences, they'll just need to get through the third semester level, so in this case, ELE 201. Any questions? Yeah, and I'm sorry, I should have listed that as a biology, they obviously can't take like biology 336, right, from area A, because that's in their major department. So yeah, they can, they just have to take something else. And sometimes a science student wants to do that. We just give them the option because they have to take so many sciences already that, or, you know, math-based courses, that we're just trying to give them that option. But yeah, for science and math majors, they can take an area A, or they can take an additional BRC for that upper division American institutions if it's not already completed. That's a great question. And then the main difference, that's considered a special provision, while engineering and nursing, for example, are considered special GE patterns. So there is a difference between a specialized GE pattern and a special provision. That makes sense?
Yeah.
So. Yes?
Going back to the unknown courses, if they're trying to register for a fall course that has a prerequisite of what they said that the community college is now unknown, can they still register for that?
It depends on if the course is a computer enforced prerequisite. So that kind of gets kind of tricky. So do you have like a specific example in mind, or you were just, yeah, so it really depends. If the student is, the problem is we're not guaranteeing the student that we're going to articulate it the way the student wants. So they're running a risk. If they go into, let's say, I'm trying to think of an example. If they go into a course, they don't have the prerequisite for it, the system actually allows them to register for it. So it's not a computer enforced. They'll get a warning, and it'll say, you don't have the prerequisite. The instructor has the right to drop them from the class. If the instructor doesn't drop them, and they're allowed to remain in the class, and they do remain in the class, and it turns out that that course was not the prerequisite, they're now responsible for that grade. And so if they fail the course, they're still responsible for the grade. So it becomes a little bit of a slippery slope. We want to be kind of careful. If we're talking about transfer students with unknown courses, most of our departments are really good about reaching out to those students and encouraging them to take their transcripts with them to orientation so that they can be looking at those courses and making decisions on the spot if they're going to count those courses as lower division so that they can go ahead and pass them into the upper division courses. Cool. Anything else? So in computer labs, just a reminder to walk around, approach and ask students how they're doing, if they need help, just really making yourself available to the students. Don't forget the importance of checking prerequisites, so computer enforced prerequisites versus prerequisite warnings. So always feel free to send or take a student or come grab an academic advisor and bring us to the student when appropriate. So there'll be advisors in the computer labs from 4 to 5:30 on freshman days. And transfer days, I believe, we go in at 3:45.
For which day?
For transfer. For computer labs.
Oh, yeah, 3:45.
3:45, correct. So I'll be there for every lab, and then my advising colleagues will be rotating dates. So just as a reminder, if there's any questions you can't answer or you're unsure of, and another ambassador can't help you, then just please refer the student to an academic advisor in the computer labs. Okay, so on the last page of your handout, we have some change of major information. This is always a hot topic of conversation. So as far as changing major and who can and when they can and things like that. So for new admit freshmen, whether they're undeclared or they're coming in as a declared major for a freshman, they will be allowed to attend another department's orientation session, except for nursing, pending that college has been represented or that major has been represented. Orientation packet will include the map and the degree evaluation for the